First, let me wish you all a very happy and prosperous new year. Also, all the passing graduates, wish you a great future ahead. Thank you, Chairman, Mr. Natarajan, and my dear friend Punusami, sir, and other dignitaries on the dais. Also, let me give a small background about what are things which you have been doing. While that introduction was good, I just want to talk about other things apart from BharatMatrimony.com. While I started as an online matchmaking service in 2000, it's going to complete 15 years. What it was, just BharatMatrimony.com till 2006. We wanted to expand beyond matrimony. We launched various other verticals. We launched job portals. We launched property portals. Event began so many other verticals. We realized in 2008, we didn't have so much of bandwidth and capital to focus on so many verticals. So we decided to focus on two verticals, matrimony and property. When we decided to focus on matrimony and property, today property has become a separate business and that being managed by a CEO. Then matrimony, normally people talk about the growth. That's what we did in 2006. We went beyond various verticals. There's so much opportunity is possible in the core category. So what was just BharatMatrimony.com online? Today, a matchmaking has become a multiple businesses. Basically, you would create a value innovation. Just online has become various businesses. We create a separate matchmaking service for rich and affluent, and also create a separate service for professionals who are busy, whom you could able to find a life partner by outsourcing their matchmaking needs to us. We launch assisted matrimony, more like outsourcing of matchmaking to us. They also set up retail outlets across India. We've taken a matrimony to the retail format. Today we have 200 outlets across India. The Bharat Matrimony approach has been a linguistic matrimony set. We have TamilMatrimony.com, TeluguMatrimony.com. That's where it started. We all know that marriage in India, it's happened within the community. We thought, why not create our own competition? We created 300 matrimony sites. Whether it's for community, whether for religion, even have a special site like defense matrimony. So one business of matchmaking of Bharat Matrimony became five business in the matchmaking. From matchmaking, now we're expanding into various other marriage services opportunity. We call it as a forward integration. Reliance was built on backward integration. Reliance started with the textile, they went backwards. And for matchmaking, you know that how much money people spend on marriage. When people come to us for matchmaking, so much we can do for the people, once they find a life partner. We have Tambulia.com, which is a marketplace model for, the marketplace model today is very hot in India, in e-commerce, whether it's a Flipkart, Snapdeal, so much opportunity in the marketplace model. We launched Tambulia.com. It's an online marketplace for people who want to buy the bulk gifts, return gifts for marriage, engagement, other occasions. We started a wedding photography service in Tamil Nadu. It's basically started with online matchmaking, now we've been expanding various from matchmaking to marriage services. What it was 1997, it's a one-man show. Today we have 4,000 associates across India. We've been funded by Yahoo and other global investors, one of the well-known internet company. When Mr. Raghavendra Ravi talked about he's one of our customer, hope he's not referring to himself, because we have plans of launching senior matrimony, so we have not done that yet. So let me share based on my experience. When I graduated, it reminds me of my special day when I got graduated. Very special feeling. So when I got graduated, my expertise was only on programming. Today, I'm running a successful organization. I want to share my experience, what led me to do what I'm today and what are the successful what you have got in life. The first and foremost, where education should not end with you got the graduation. The quest for learning should continue till the end. Because today, the world is changing so rapidly, much more than ever. Today, technology, the kind of advance is taking place. It's changing so rapidly. What is relevant 2 years before is no more relevant. With a fast-moving world, changing technology, connected world, it's important that your quest for learning and continuous learning should be there and should continue. In fact, what I was the programmer today became a successful CEO, one thing what I done successfully is that ensure that I've been continuously learning and improving. In fact, I used to wonder when I started the business, I did not have that management expertise, I did not have the financial understanding, I did not have the marketing understanding. But one thing I ensured that, let me learn, let me improve, let me get better on all those expertise. Today, I could able to give a leadership to what are the kind of people I'm recruiting in the organization. We have people from very reputed organization, IAMs and IAM, what are the different, the pedigree where people come from. So it's important that you need to continuously improve, learn and get better. So education should not stop just with the graduation. That's the first learning I want to give. The second thing is that working out, very, very important. When the world tells you to go for a mile, go that extra mile. I want to share a personal story shared by my Guru Magathriya. When he got engaged, before the engagement, used to drive a two-wheeler, at the speed of, I'm talking about 20 years ago, 25 years ago, 90 kilometers, that's the speed he used to drive. Post the engagement, till the marriage year sometimes, you want to take his fiancé out. Just to ensure that because the girl is not married, he wants to ensure that he's been driving safely. He was driving at around 60 kilometers per hour for a couple of months. Once in a while, he get the opportunity to take his fiancé out. Post the marriage, because obviously marriage has happened, so sees his wife, then he said, look, I can drive whatever the speed I wanted. When he wanted to drive to 90 kilometers, the speed which he used to drive earlier, the vehicle did not go beyond certain kilometers. Then he went for a servicing, then he said, given the full throttle, it was not going beyond the 70-80 kilometers. He was wondering why that, you know, vehicle used to go at 90 kilometers per hour was not going. Given for car, the two-wheeler for servicing also, it was not happening. Actually, the realization was that even the vehicle got used to the mediocre performance, doesn't go to the peak performance. The hard working should not be that tomorrow let me start a business, let me work hard. When you got a job, we ask you to work for 8 hours, work for 12 hours. In fact, for first job, I used to come on weekends, work day and night. The hard working was part of my nature. It's not that once I start a business, let me work hard. So hard working, it's very, very important. I hope that most of people know Tamil here. Even Thiruvalluvar says, Devathal agadeninum muyarchi than meivarutha koolitharum. Even if God cannot give, your hard work can give the desired results. So hard work is very, very important. To work hard, even that today in the organization, we give the more responsibility. Even that Mr. Natarajan has also told when his speech was mentioning about, take the challenges, take the thing opportunities. If there is an opportunity in your career and people are looking for that someone can take the responsibility, take the responsibility. I remember my first job, I just joined Nucleus. There are 1,000 plus employees. When there was a earthquake, they wanted to collect the funding, I volunteered myself. So the guy had quit, he was the cultural club president. When he had quit, he had nominated me for the cultural club president, where I was just first year into the career, because he had seen I was volunteering that the social service responsibility. When you take accountability and responsibility, you see that you'll gain more responsibility. That's opportunity for you to kind of grow in career. So hardworking, very, very important. Let the hardworking be part of your nature. The third thing I want to share is that unintended consequences. In your career, when you take the responsibility, you may sometimes wonder why certain things are happening which is not in line with my expectation. In fact, my career has been shaped by unintended consequences. I'm a firm believer of unintended consequences will produce far better results than intended consequences. Steve Jobs even told his Stanford graduation day address, you can only connect dot backwards. What is you can connect only dot backwards? Certain things happening in your life which is not in line with your expectation. sometimes wondering why it's happening. In my life, after my plus two, I want to do BSc chemistry. Because what I want to BSc chemistry is because my uncle told me, go for BSc chemistry, you get a laboratory job. That was my ambition. I applied for BSc chemistry. I couldn't get BSc chemistry. What I got was statistics. I want chemistry. I want to get a laboratory job, but I didn't get BSc chemistry. But what I got statistics. When was in the final year of my BSc statistics, one of my senior told me, isn't it good in maths and logics? Why don't you apply for MCE? I was not even aware of there is a course called MCE. When I applied for MCA, the chemistry which I wanted was not eligible to apply, whereas the statistics which I did not want was eligible to apply. Me getting into MCA changed my life because I realized my potential in a computer programming. There are many incidents in my life. I started business in 2000. I got married through my own service. I wanted to come full time into the business. I was contemplating when to come full time in the business. I was in US supporting the business. Then I got laid off. I said, wow, it's a great opportunity. Because if I had not got laid off, I would have continued to do my full time job. I would have not able to devote time into my venture. So me getting laid off, was able to focus full time in the business, the BharatMatrimony was taken off. Even when I want to raise the money, there are instances where I met all the VCs, I was not able to raise the money. Then the Yahoo came. I was not even wanted to meet Yahoo because Yahoo being a global internet company, being a strategic investor, I don't want to take the money from the Yahoo. The investment banker told, look, let's go and meet. But finally, I was able to get Yahoo as a regular investor. Basically, the many incidents in life, even the big turnover happened in the year 2008 when there was a global slowdown. After raising $20 million of funding in 2008 and the slowdown happened, there's a direction of the board that you have to cut costs and you have become efficient. Again, that was not what I wanted. In 2009, I was able to control the cost. It was the most challenging situation what I went through. But the challenging situation helped me to become a CEO from an entrepreneur where, because till then I was focusing only on few aspects of the business, technology and innovation. But challenge made me to get into all the aspects of the business, was able to convert myself from an entrepreneur into a successful CEO. So the unintended consequences will produce far better results than intended consequences. This is after you putting your best efforts. It should not be the case that whatever happens is for good. No, whatever happens is for good, provided you put your best efforts. So unintended consequences, because we cannot control life. But what you can do, you can put your best efforts. Then, job versus a career. This sometimes the people make the mistake. It's very important that whether you're choosing a job or choosing a career. My first programmer, she was a gold medalist. We are just a 3-member startup. I was able to convince a gold medalist to join us. More than me convincing her, she chose our company. She made a right decision. She wanted a career, not the job. Because I was able to tell her our future, our vision, able to tell her this is what we are going to become. She could have got a job at Infosys, Wipro, being the gold medalist, but chose to join us today. 10 years down the line, a programmer today becomes a chief portal officer. She is today one of the well-known person in India, managing few hundred people, our expertise in internet mobile, something unparalleled. So many times, the people make the mistake of, oh, that company paying more salary compared to this company, where you have the opportunity to learn and improve a meaningful contribute. If you have the opportunity to learn, contribute and grow compared to another company which can pay a better salary, sometimes people making the mistake of, oh, my friend is getting so much of salary, let me go and join the company because that company provides a similar salary. It's become a peer pressure. I've seen the people making the mistake because of peer pressure. It's not about how much salary you are making today compared to your friend. Yes, so much to go in life, so many years ahead of in your life. It should not be raised that, you know, decide in 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, I'm making so much of salary compared to my friend. At 10 years down the line, 20 years down the line, you should be the person known in the industry or known that you have achieved something like are leading something significant. So don't make the mistake of comparing a salary with the peers that, hey, this person making so much salary, let me also make so much of salary by compromising your career, opportunity to learn and all the thing. My strong advice to you, don't choose job, choose a career. In fact, if you choose a job which you really enjoy, it's no more of job. Is composing music for A.R. Rahman is a job? Playing cricket for Virat Kohli, Dhoni is a job? If you enjoy what you are doing, you are flowing the flow. Only if you are resisting what you are doing, you are working. Meaning, if you are doing something against your heart, you are compromising something. So choose something you really enjoy. There may be situation in life. I understand, I was in U.S. for 6 months, I was doing the testing job. Because I gone to the U.S., that was the first job. But eventually I found my passion in programming, I was able to get the job, which was my passion. Obviously, I was able to flow with my flow. So it's important that, yeah, understand sometimes because of financial constraint, because of family background, you may be choosing some job which may not be what your heart wanted. But I request you eventually should find a job. Because if you stay in the job against your heart for too long, you get compressed into the thing that, you know, you may not be able to get the best in you. To get the best in you, you should find something where your heart also likes. If something you really enjoy, then you can able to contribute and able to grow. So don't choose a job, choose the career. Being entrepreneur, today it is a great time for India. In fact, 10 years ago, you should think in the internet company, creating a $1 billion valuation itself, we used to think that, wow, it's a significant achievement. Today, you might have already know that the companies are raising $1 billion as a private equity. Forget about being the valuation. Today, so many internet companies in India, the valuation already crossed a multi-billion-dollar. A phenomenal opportunity for, you all know that, the growing middle class. Already India has 200 million internet users. Currently, the mobile internet is going to be a very big growth. We expect to see in the next few years. In 2015, the internet users going to, from 2015 to 2020, we expect the internet users to going to grow. In multi-dimension, mobile internet is going to be something really big. There's so much opportunity in the internet space. And today, people are looking at India. Definitely, you have the stable government, no doubt about it. Not only that, the global investors are looking at to invest in India. There's so much opportunity. The people want to become entrepreneur. My advice is, join the company, get the some kind of expertise, but no better time to start into the entrepreneurship. So much opportunities, so much of angel funding available. People want to invest big in a small startup. I myself being part of Chennai Angel and Global Super Angel. So many angel investors are available. So many VC people are looking at investing big in the right business idea. So people looking at starting entrepreneur, you should ask three questions. What problem or what opportunity am I addressing? That's the first question you should ask. What problem? What opportunity I'm going to address? Second thing is, how big the opportunity? It should not be, okay, I'm going to address only a 10 crore opportunity. Is the opportunity much big enough? It's not that what it is today, in 10 years down the line or 5 years down the line, it can be $1 billion opportunity or $100 million opportunity. Is the opportunity big enough? Third question is, do you have the right team? If you have the idea is big enough, if you have the right team begin, people are willing to put the money behind your idea. And it's a phenomenal opportunity for people who want to, because today, within few years, people are able to create multi-billion dollar businesses. There's so many success happening in the internet space. Internet definitely going to be very big. Again, you can choose your area of expertise, your domain, whatever be that thing. But entrepreneur, something, it's highly recommendable, because India definitely wants more entrepreneurs, because entrepreneurs are the backbone, because they are the one creating the wealth and revenue for the country. Finally, you should leave your mark in this world. It's not about what you are today. Your life should not be limited only to yourself or your family. Would you able to make a difference to at least 100 people before you die? For that, definitely either you're in a career or in entrepreneurship, you should definitely make an impact, either make money and do the good, or you can be part of the people who can do the doing the good things. And Actually, we are launching an app in another couple of days called A Good Makes Noise. You can do something to society in your own way. Because the app what you are developing, Good Makes Noise. It's not that we are not living in a bad world. But only thing is, the good doesn't make the noise. So we thought, why not create an app? I'm just announcing it today. While the people in our organization is aware of it, that you are going to launch the app in a couple of days. It's just a small app what you develop, where if you come across, if you hear, if you experience any goodness, come and share through this app, Good Makes Noise. Let's make the world the better place. So we talked about Bharat Blood Bank, Bharat Eye Bank. So whatever the capacity in which you can able to make a difference to the society, that because you should live that before the end of you living this world and all the thing, you should have made this world a better place by your own contribution. It should not be you are just born and you lived your life and you ended a life. You should definitely make a difference to the life. To sum it up, the learning should not be limited to you got getting the graduation. The learning should continue till the end of your life. The Walmart, Sam Walton, after creating a multi-billion dollar business, even he was in deathbed, he was reading. So learning should continue, because that's the only way you could be able to differentiate yourself compared to the others. Second thing was hard work. Hard work should be part of your nature. If the world tells you go for a mile, go that extra mile. End of the day, you should ask, did I meaningfully contribute today? Hard work. Choose the career, not a job. Don't make the mistake of taking a job because high paying salary compared to the career which can able to give the opportunity for you to learn and contribute. And in life, if something happens which not in line with your expectation, have the faith that whatever is happening is for good, but you have to put the best effort. Unintended consequences will produce far better than intended consequences. Have the faith that everything happens in the life is for good only. Have the faith, continue to put your best effort, eventually see those incidents what you have thought that challenging incident could have become the turning points in your life. And entrepreneurs, enough and more opportunity for people who want to become entrepreneur. If you get the idea, India is a completely unorganized market. It takes some idea which is unorganized, make it organized, put the professional service. The business which are getting into wedding photograph business, it's unorganized business. It's not a something you're creating new. It's an unorganized business. Make it organized, bring the professionalism, create a brand, you got the business. The phenomenal opportunity for entrepreneurs. Finally, your life should not be limited to you and your family. Before you leave this world, you should have definitely make a difference to the society and made a meaningful contribution, if not to millions of people, which you can do. You can make a difference to millions of people, at least 100 or 1,000 of people, you should have made the difference in their life. Once again, I wish all the graduates wish you very best in life, do extremely very well, create a multi-billion dollar business, or become the CEO of the companies, or maybe the head of the thing, whatever in your own capacity. Just put the best efforts and do very well. Thank you so much.